I've talked to some business people, one of the leading business people in Boston in my office just last week. I understand people who think we have too much regulation, but I think the analog here is to the pharmaceutical industry, where the major pharmaceutical companies might not like some of what the FDA has, but they've worked to provide the FDA with enough money to carry it out. You might think that less regulation would be better, but clearly the worst of all worlds is to have regulations on the books and have regulatory authorities that aren't able to deal with them appropriately. They can't hire the right people and have the right information technology. So this nickel and diming, the SEC and the CFTC, I think does grave harm, and it's of course a catch-22 to complain that they aren't moving appropriately with the rules, but then deny them the funding to do it. And I have to say this, for people who are prepared to have America stay in Iraq for a couple more years, and I was encouraged when my colleague from Alabama talked about the military-industrial complex. Let's work on cutting them down, too, to help. But when people tell me they want to stay in Iraq over the Bush administration's decision to get out at a cost of billions and billions, but we can't find $150 million for the CFTC, I'm not impressed. And let's be clear with the SEC that that's an area where there's no taxpayer money. Finally, I do want to talk about Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. I have to say here, let me be a little partisan. I am impressed with the on-again, off-again nature of this with my colleagues in the House. I don't hear address the Senate. My Republican colleagues in the House talk very tough about Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac when they were in the minority. But when they are in the majority, something happens. They are affected by a strange kind of paralysis that comes with responsibility. I say that because last year, when we dealt with this bill in conference, the Republicans in the House offered the Henseling bill, a total abolition of Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, with no particular attention to its succession, as an amendment. We said no. We said it wasn't germane. We have now been, we're now almost 7 months into this session with the Republicans in the majority. Mr. Henseling is a member of the majority. He's a subcommittee chairman. They haven't offered it. In fact, we had a discussion about some smaller bills to deal with this, which the Wall Street Journal said was a poor way to do it. And here's what Mr. Backus said. I speak for all members of all the subcommittee chairs. We would like a comprehensive bill. This is on Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. Now, can we get a comprehensive bill? I don't know. I don't think so. So the Republicans in power in the House are much less certain. The gentleman from Alabama said, where are we? Well, I don't know. Ask your colleague from Alabama on the next plane ride home. And I will say this, somewhat embarrassed by this failure of memory once he became the majority, the gentleman from Alabama blamed the Obama administration. And this is really extraordinary, and I'll close with this. Of all the issues in all the world, I feel like Humphrey Bogart in Casablanca, in all the issues in all the world, when it comes to Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, the Republicans in the House can't proceed without Obama. Why haven't we seen one? Because Obama won't let them do it. I suppose a more recent entertainment analogy is, for those who remember, Flip Wilson, in which the Republicans in the House are Geraldine, and Obama is the devil who won't let them do it. And the chairman said inaccurately, I am sure he misunderstood, that he was asked by the Obama administration to wait. I have checked with the Secretary of Treasury, I have checked with HUD, I have checked with the administration. He misunderstood them. No one in the Obama administration is asking him to wait. And the notion that they can't proceed on Fannie and Freddie, that they have said, may I, to the Obama administration, and they haven't gotten permission. I have a rule that I try to follow myself. I would advise this to my Republican colleagues here. No matter how tight the corner you're in because of problems, try to avoid saying something that no one will believe.